Hey guys, today we're going to look at how to play the drum part of the song Uptown Funk. The first part goes just like this. So the first part of the song goes like this. You're playing quarter notes on the bass drum. You're going to play eighth notes on the hi-hat. Three and four and one and two and three and four. And then we're going to play snare on two and four. So when we put it all together, it goes a little something like this. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. Okay, so the tricky part is to get the open hi-hat accent on the end of four. So to do that, all we have to do is loosen your left foot just a little to get that sizzle sound. So it's going to go like this. One and two and three and four and one. One more time, a little slower. One and two and three and four and one. Okay? So that's going to happen every two bars. Okay, so it's gonna, when we put it all together, it goes like this. One and two and three and four and two and two and three and four and one. Okay, so that's gonna repeat over and over in the first part of the song. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. The next part of the song, we strip everything away, and then all we're going to play is quarter notes on the bass drum for four bars, just like this. So we're going to do that for four bars, and then we're going to move and do a little drum fill with the snare and the floor tom. And we're going to use a little thing called, in music, called a crescendo. So we're going to start really quiet, and as we go along, we're going to build it up and get louder and louder. So I'm going to play on the edge of the drum to get the really quiet sound. And as I get louder, I'm going to get closer and closer to the center. So it goes like this. Just like that. So the next part of the song goes a little something like this. So the next part of the song is just like the first part, but this time we have a drum fill on the snare that's going to be 16th notes starting on the end of three. So it goes something like this. One and two and three. Do that one more time a little slower. One and two and three and four and one. Like that. Okay, so if we put it all together, we're going to have two bars of the drum beat, and then we're going to have the 16th note drum fill on the end of three. So it goes like this. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. Just like that. So to play that drum fill, it's really simple. You just move your right hand over to the snare on the end of three. And you just play singles, right, left, right, left. So we'll do that again slow. One and two and three and four and one. In the next part of the song, the beat goes away and we do that drum fill quite a bit more. So it looks like this. So in this next part of the song, what we're going to do is, instead of doing two bars and then the drum fill, we're just going to do one bar, do that same drum fill and repeat that three more times, and then the end of that section, we're going to do a slightly more complicated fill on the snare, but it's really not that hard, and I'll explain to you how to do it in just a second. So I'll demonstrate that for you slowly. One and two and three. One and two and three. One and two and three. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to do that little drum fill with the break there. So what we're doing is we're doing right on the snare, followed by a bass drum, and then a flam. So the flam is hitting the sticks at the same time on the snare, but just slightly one beat after another. So if I do it slowly, it goes right, left, slam, right, left, slam. And then we're going to break with an accent on the hi-hat and the bass drum at the same time. And again, the accent on the hi-hat is just lifting up the pressure with your left foot and then getting that open hi-hat accent like that. So you don't want to take your foot completely off the pedal. All you have to do is release the pressure a little bit and you'll get that sizzle accent. So if I do that again, it goes like this. That's like that. Really slow. That's pretty much the whole song. There's one more beat that you have to get, which goes at the end of the song. And it's pretty much the same beat that we were doing on the hi-hat in the beginning, but this time we're going to move your right hand over to the ride cymbal, and we're going to play accents on the end. So on one, and, two, and, three, and, we're going to play those on the bell of the cymbal. And so to get that, we're going to use the shaft of the drumstick. So we're going to play the tip on one, and then the shaft on the ends. Okay, so it goes like this. One, and two, and three, and four, and. Just like that. Okay? So now if we put that all together with the bass drum, the quarter notes on one, two, three, four, snare on two and four, it goes like this. Going to slow that down, and it really helps to count just so that it all comes together. So it goes like this. One and two.